everyone. In last class, we have solved question number 15 of 2019 MCET examination paper. Now we are going to start with 16. That is, in actual question paper, it is 96. So in this question, it says that there is a copper ball and its diameter is 3 mm and it falls into a oil tank which contains oil of viscosity 1 kg like this. Then we have to find the terminal velocity of this copper ball, and density of oil is given and density of copper ball is also given. We know that gravitational force G is equals to 10 meters per second square. Now let us solve this problem. We know that the terminal velocity is given by this expression, that is Vt is equals to 2 upon 9 R. R is radius of ball and sigma stands for density of copper ball and this rho is density of oil and G is given, that is 10, and this one is viscosity of the oil. If you substitute the values, we will be getting 2 upon 9, 3 into 10 power minus 3. So we are converting this into meters. Then sigma is equals to 9 into 10 power 3 and rho is 1.5 into 10 power 3 and G is substituted here. If you solve this one, you will be getting 15 into 10 power minus 2 meters per second, which is your answer. Now let us move on to next question. In the question, which states that the wavelength of the radiation emitted by a black body is 1 mm and Wien's constant is also given, then we have to find the temperature of black body. Before we solve this problem, we should know what is Wien's displacement law. Wien's displacement law states that the wavelength of a black body is inversely proportional to its temperature, or we can say that temperature of any black body is inversely proportional to its wavelength. So by using this, we can easily find out the temperature of black body because we already have the wavelength, that is 1 mm, and Wien's constant. To remove this proportionality, we have to introduce a constant which is known as Wien's constant. Then this equation will become T is equals to, suppose, constant B upon lambda. If you look at this one, here it is given that lambda T is equals to B. That is, lambda is wavelength, T is temperature of the body and B is Wien's constant. If you substitute all these values, you will be getting this T is equals to, if you take this lambda to this side, it will become T is equals to this constant, Wien's constant, upon the wavelength, that is 1 mm. We have to convert it into meters. It will become 1 into 10 power minus 3. Solve this one, you will be getting T is equals to 3 Kelvin, which is option A. This is your right answer. Remember, the units here are very important because a simple formula, that is lambda is proportional to temperature, can solve this problem. But if you forgot to change the units of wavelength, that is given in mm, if it could have been given in meters, then the answer will be different value. You have to take care of units before solving any problem. In this question, it is said that a Carnot engine with certain efficiency between two heat reservoirs. It means that there are two heat reservoirs. One is at T1 temperature and another one is T2 temperature. It is given that T1 is greater than T2. So heat is flowing from T1 to T2. As we know that heat flows from higher temperature to lower temperature. So it is given that if only T1 is changed by 0.4%, then the efficiency is this one, and whereas T2 is changed by 0.2%, the efficiency will be this one. So we have to find out the ratio between delta efficiency 1 upon delta efficiency 2. We know that efficiency of Carnot engine is given by this expression, that is efficiency is equals to 1 minus T2 upon T1. You can write it as T1 minus T2 upon T1 also. Okay, we know that the percentage error in efficiency is given by change in efficiency upon original efficiency is equals to delta T1 upon T1 plus delta T2 upon T2. Now in question it is given that T1 is changed by 0.4%, then if you substitute the values in this expression, we'll be getting change in efficiency 1 upon efficiency is equals to 0.4 upon 100. For change in T2, that is 0.2% in T2 temperature, we'll be getting change in efficiency 2 upon efficiency is equals to 2 upon 100. We need the ratio between these two, that is change in efficiency 1 upon change in efficiency 2. The ratio is calculated as change in efficiency 1 upon change in efficiency 2, which is equals to 0.4 upon 0.2. So the final answer will be 2, that is this one times and this cuts into 2 times. Now let us move on to next question. In this question it is said that there is an ideal gas in a closed container and is heated so that the final RMS speed of the gas particles is increases by 2 times the initial RMS speed. If the initial gas temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, then we have to find the final temperature of this ideal gas. We know that the RMS velocity of the ideal particles is directly proportional to under root temperature. So if we look at the ratio of the speed and temperature, V1 square upon V2 square is equals to T1 upon T2. That is, this root comes to this side, it will become square. So if we substitute the values, that is V1 is as it is and V2 is given as 2 times of V1, that is 2 times the initial RMS speed. If we square it, it will become 4V1 square. So cancel out this V1 square and this V1 square. So remaining will be 1 upon 4 is equals to 300 upon X. Now X is equals to 300 into 4. Then final temperature will be 1200 Kelvin. Now take care of units. Here we are getting in Kelvin, but this, if you put this option, it will be wrong answer because this is given in Celsius. So you have to convert this into Celsius first, then you have to substitute the answer. If you convert this 1200 into Celsius, it will be 1200 minus 273 degrees Celsius, that is 927 degrees Celsius. Remember, whenever you solve a problem, you should remember the units, that is you have to convert temperature into Kelvin and then solve the problem. So thank you for watching the video. Please share with your friends.